Hello and welcome to our new OutPower tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to check the key differences between traditional web applications and reactive web applications. Without further ado, let's get right to it. Reactive web applications offer what we currently can get on the mobile apps, but with improvements that facilitate the creation of web and mobile applications. The key points that make the traditional web application differ from the reactive web application are the following. On the traditional web app, our logic is executed on the server side, while on the reactive web application, it can be executed on the client and server side. All client-side logic can be visually modular, instead of relying only on hard-to-maintain JavaScript. The flexibility to design client-side actions and server-side actions is the same. When triggering a server-side action from the client side, OutSystems generates and secures REST APIs behind the scenes to support the communication between browser and server, using only the minimum network bandwidth required for actual data transfer. When developing a traditional web app, we need to consider that all of our requests are synchronous, meaning you do a request, then get the response, and so on. While on the reactive website, we can trigger several requests and then deal with the response once they are ready. Asynchronism in server communication keeps your apps always responsive. While an app is executing a server-side action, it continues to run and respond to user input in the browser. Also, the two types of applications work with different types of rendering. On the traditional web, we have explicit server-side rendering. We have to make a server request to refresh a screen or part of a screen. And on the reactive web, we have the client-side rendering. What this means is, all UI elements update immediately when the data that they are bound to changes. First thing that should be pointed out is when creating an application, the new library module is available from the picker. This allows us to build applications with a solid architecture right from the very start. These libraries can be used in both reactive and mobile apps. The previously known OutSystems UI Mobile is now called OutSystems UI. This is an important update to support a single UI framework for all your apps. But the traditional app application will still use the OutSystems UI Web. With reactive web applications, instead of using preparation, you'll find screen data directly below the screen. Screen data can be a mix of aggregates, data actions, and variables. As before, aggregates provide easy access to entities' data, while data actions can be used for more advanced cases, like fetching data from external services. All these are executed asynchronously and in parallel. This will improve your app's user experience, since there is no need to wait for all the data to arrive before starting to display the page. In the traditional method, we would prepare all of our data in the preparation, and the screen would only render once everything had been executed. OutSystems added the fetch property with onStart and onDemand options to screen aggregates and data actions. Now, we can implement patterns such as master detail with an excellent performance and user experience. As we spoke before, now we can execute client and server actions. When executing the client actions, we can make calls to the server and we can reuse other client actions. Also, when setting a client action as a function, we cannot use server actions in its flow. Apart from that, they both let us design our logic in a similar way. With this new technology, OutSystems warns you whenever it creates some scalability anti-pattern. For example, when you call server action inside a loop and do something that might delay the screen rendering, or sequentially call server actions, OutSystems suggests alternatives for the best performance. Now, all UI elements update immediately when the data that they are bound to changes. While in the traditional web applications, we control the update on the screen with the use of the AJAX refresh. This implies for us to change our tactics when trying to implement screen updates. Using this little demo, let's use a client action to demonstrate the data changing on the screen as we mess with it. Form validations have also changed a bit. In the traditional web apps, we would have to set client and server, server or none, on the button validation. In reactive web apps, it is similar, but we are only prompted with the option for yes or no for built-in validation. Finally, WebBlocks. The biggest difference is that now we can trigger events from the WebBlocks that allow us to pass information to the parent element. Otherwise, this will only be possible by means of notify messages triggered from the WebBlock, which after a while it can become a bit cumbersome. Another feature that is worth mentioning is that we can set the WebBlock to react to the onChange of an input variable, triggering the WebBlock to refresh its content. That will be all for today. We hope that with this tutorial, you will be able to understand a bit better some of the differences between traditional web applications and reactive web applications. Please join us next time for more OutSystems tutorials.